Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My dear friends, this morning we start this reflection with a short prayer. Let us all close our eyes before the Lord and ask for His grace that we might all be enlightened to understand His words, His plan for us, for our people, for our country, for our families, for our children. Lord Jesus, we thank you. We adore you. We glorify you for this wonderful occasion that you have given us to think about your words, to think about your plans for us. Lord Jesus, protect us. Keep us always under your wings, under your protection. Keep our families, our children, our nation, our political leaders, so that we might be enlightened with your words, that we might go along the right path that you have showed us. Mother Mary, intercede for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So this reflection begins with the words from the Holy Scriptures, Psalm 23. Psalm 23 is very familiar to you. I know that. It's about the Lord who is our shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Indeed, the Lord God tells us we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Hallelujah. This is a promise that God gives us. He has given us, and He does every day what He has promised us. He is very faithful. He never fails in His promise. Perhaps we human beings, we might fail, but God never fails. He has carved us out of His own palms. Even before we were formed in the womb of our mothers, He chose us. We are chosen ones. That is what St. Peter says. We are a chosen race. We are a chosen people, a priestly people. Indeed, we are a priestly people chosen by Jesus Christ. He is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. What does a shepherd do? A shepherd, he is leading his sheep. Where? To where? He will lead his sheep to the pastures, to the still waters, to the place where they can take rest under the shadow. And that is what Lord God promises us. And I shall not want anything. If He is my shepherd, He will take care of me. Why should you worry about that? When you get difficulties in your life, don't be discouraged. Because the Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. He is faithful in His promise. And He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He makes me. He knows what I need. And He will lead me to those pastures. To lie down there so that I might get a good day's rest. I'm tired because of my daily heavy work. When I come back from my work, I'm tired. I'm fed up with my family problems, but the Lord is with me. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. The only condition that the Lord puts before us is that we should be open to Him. We should accept His invitation. And He leads me beside the still waters. Water gives life. Without water, what is life? The life, you know, cannot grow up without water. And He leads me to the still waters. Still waters, not dangerous ones. You have, most of you have seen, you know, the sea waves. How dangerous it is when the waves are so high to jump into the sea water. Lord is not leading us to the, you know, high seas. He is leading us to the still waters where there is peace, where there is calmness, where there is happiness, where there is harmony, where there is being together. So He is leading us beside the still waters that gives you life, that, you know, energizes your spiritual life, your mental life, your physical life. He restores my soul. Yes, there are times when we are put down by other people. Perhaps you, when you are in the workplace, your boss might have put you down. Doesn't matter. Don't worry about that. The Lord restores my soul. He's always there. Forget about what your boss has done to you. Forget about what your parents have done to you. Forget about what your friends, so-called friends, have done to you. The Lord is there to restore your soul. So don't worry about the difficulties, problems, crises in your life, because the God is always there. He is my shepherd. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. He leads me in the paths of righteousness. My dear friends, righteousness, what is that? It's not merely, you know, doing some just things. It is not merely the justice that we talk about in the daily lives. Righteousness means to be like God. When we are righteous, we will be worthy to be beside God. Yes, you know, when a child becomes worthy to be in the lap of his father, when that child is that father's son, you don't put every child in your lap always, but whenever your son, your daughter comes to you, you take him or her with great love and care and put him or her in your lap. So that is what God does when you are righteous. Righteous means you are becoming sons and daughters of God. You are God-like. So He leads me in the paths of righteousness even when you go wrong. Then He brings you back to your original nature. He has created us in His own image and likeness. So we are like Him. We are like God. And He leads me in the paths of that image and likeness to be right like Him. For His name's sake, His name's sake, God said to Moses, I am. Moses asked God, what's your name? When the people will ask me, what is your name? What shall I say? God said, I am. I am the one who am. I am the one who exists right from the beginning. I have no beginning. So that is what He says, for His name's sake. Yeah. Though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil. we may have chances, we may have occasions to walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Our friends may not accept all that we believe as Christians, as Catholics. It doesn't matter. Even when we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil because the Lord is my shepherd. Because He is leading me, because He is beside me, He is always with me. Why should I worry about other people who would like to, you know, do something, some harm to me? Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. You know, back in Kerala, in India, sometimes people are very afraid to go near the cemetery where people are buried. They say that, you know, they think that the spirits of the people who died in sin, they walk around, they move around. Absolutely a nonsense. Don't worry about that. The spirits, the souls of the dead people, they never walk around. But at the same time, remember, evil spirits are there. The evil force is in the world. But even when you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, where those evil spirits move around, I will fear no evil because the Lord is my shepherd. He's there to protect me. For you are with me. The Bible, that R is in italics. Why? Because the Bible wants to emphasize that word. You are with me. That R means always. It's in the present. It's not in the past tense. It's not in the future tense. It's in the present tense. You are with me. Lord doesn't say, you will be with me. Lord Jesus said to the good thief, you will be with me today in heaven. And that is not what He said here. The Lord says, you are with me. Always with me. I'm with you. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me, says the psalmist. The shepherd has a rod, like the bishops. And your staff, again the same thing. That comfort me. Because that is a sign which gives me courage to go ahead. Yes, when the shepherd leads the flock, leads the sheep with his rod, with his staff, they know that. He's always there to give us to eat, to drink, to protect us from the wild animals, from the thieves, no matter who comes. He will die for us. So don't worry. When you see that rod and staff, my dear friends, the cross of Jesus Christ is that rod and staff for us Catholics, Christians. When you see that somewhere, remember that they are comforting you. That is a symbol, a sign that you are beside the Lord Jesus Christ. He is your shepherd. He is protecting you. The psalmist continues, you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Can you eat when somebody is coming to attack you? No, absolutely no. You will lose all your, you know, hunger. You will not have any feeling to eat. So the Lord says, the psalmist says, you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. What does it mean? That means even before the enemies, you will be so peaceful as to enjoy a good meal. So, we enjoy good ice cream. We enjoy a good steak. We enjoy, you know, good food. And in order to enjoy that, you must have peace in mind. You must be happy enough. You must have an environment in which you can peacefully eat without being afraid of your enemies. And the Lord will take care to prepare before me, before my enemies, a table full of good, you know, things to eat. It simply means, no matter what happens, No matter what kind of difficulties you are going through, no matter what kind of illness or sickness you are passing through, He's always there. As you enjoy a good meal, He will give you the courage. He will give you the opportunity to enjoy your being, your existence with God. You anoint my head with oil. Oil is a symbolic thing. When, for example, you are confirmed, you receive the Holy Sacrament of Confirmation, which is called the Syro Malabar Church Chrismation. You know, during Chrismation, the minister anoints you on the forehead with the holy oil. And that is a symbol of the Holy Spirit, that you receive the Holy Spirit. When you are baptized, you are baptized, you are anointed with the holy oil, symbolizing that you receive the Holy Spirit. You receive the Spirit of Jesus. And wherever you are, you anoint my head with oil. So you give your spirit to me always. Spirit in the sense that you get the courage. You get the same spirit as Jesus Christ. When Jesus Christ could face even death on the cross. Why? Because He was God and He knew exactly what He was up to. And when the Spirit is within you, you will be able to do the same thing. So that is the meaning, you anoint my head with oil. Every day, my dear friends, you are anointed with oil. That is the Holy Spirit. Just be open to the Spirit. Just be open, open to the Spirit. Open your hearts so that He can come in. If you close everything, you remain in darkness. You have seen huge trucks with, 20 to 24 tires, wheels. And what is inside a wheel or tire? It's not concrete. It's not iron. It's not steel. It's not anything of that sort. Merely air. And this air, when the tire of the wheel is full of air, this truck is capable of carrying hundreds of thousands of tons of material. But remember, a few of the tires get blasted. No more air in it. The truck will not be able to carry forward, to move forward with the weight on it. The same way, when the Spirit is within us, when we are filled with the Spirit, we will be able to move forward no matter what kind of weight is put on us, over us. We will be able to carry them. Maybe sickness, maybe a mortgage, maybe a bad, maybe some bad character of your children. Doesn't matter. You will be able to move forward because the Spirit is within you. You are filled with the Holy Spirit. My cup runs over. My cup runs over. That means you will have an abundance of the graces of God. God doesn't give you just the minimum. No. He gives always to you the maximum. Even beyond what you need in your daily life may not be money. May not be as you think, the things useful to you, but as God thinks. Remember, God always gives you in abundance. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Certainly, I believe goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. This is the trust that the psalmist places in his Lord. Yes, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Why should I worry? This life is not the end of everything. We have a life after. We have a life after. And all the days of my life, goodness and mercy shall follow me, provided I have the Spirit in me. Spirit of Jesus fills me. Then I will have all these things. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. when you have all these things, what does it mean? You are in the house of the Lord. You are no more an outsider. You are no more somebody, you know, somebody who is like a hireling. You are not a servant. You are not a worker in your family. You are the son. You will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Remember the parable of that prodigal son. You know, the prodigal son, when he got back the senses, he said to himself, I'm a sinner. I have sinned against you, against my father and heavens. Now what shall I do? I'll get up, go to my father. I'll tell my father, Father, I have sinned against you and heavens. Now forgive me, pardon me. I will never do that. I know that I was your son, but I lost that sonship because of what I have done against you. You wanted me to remain with you, but I did something wrong. I thought something else. I thought things were much better outside. So I got my share from your wealth, my inheritance. I got it from you, and you gave it to me. Then I took them all away. I spent them all away, squandered the money, enjoyed life with my friends. Well, with the friends whom I thought that they were friends, but they were not actually friends. Now, what happened? Finally, I'm here to rear the pigs. As far as a Jew is concerned, that is the worst job. He will never do that. Touching a pig was abominous for a Jew. It was forbidden by law. But I'm just doing that. Now he got back his senses. He's getting up. And he says, I will go back to my father. But I will remain there not as a son, just as a servant. And he goes back. But the father, he was always, you know, looking ahead. And he knew that one day my child will return. My son will return. But this father wanted the child, the son, to return on his own. The father is not going out in search of his son. He is just sitting on the veranda of his house. And then there comes his son. And with open arms, as soon as he comes and prostrates before his father, he embraces him. Says, my son, come in. Let us enjoy. Let us celebrate this situation that you have come back. You were dead, my son. Now you have come back. But the son, he wanted to say to the father, Father, I have sinned against you and God. Don't consider me anymore your son, but just your servant. He doesn't say anything. The father doesn't answer to the son his questions or his, you know, things like that. He just orders the servants, you know, bring all the best dress, bring the ring, bring the sandals, put on him. Let us celebrate. What does it symbolize? That means, you know, ring, I have the ring here. This shows authority, an episcopal authority. In the former days, kings had rings. Their, you know, official seal was this ring. So putting on the ring means the father is giving back the authority of his son to this lost son. Father doesn't care whether the son had been with the prostitutes or with other people like that, but he just receives him just as before because he is his son. My dear brothers and sisters, this is what God does. When you return to God, he receives us as if you were always there. The only condition is that you repent. And then I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Yes, that is what God promises us. That is what, you know, God did for us, does every day for us. We shall be ever grateful. our God. We have a God who gave everything to ourselves, to us. He gave himself to us in the Holy Eucharist. Always, he gives himself to us. There's no other religion in which the God himself fully has given himself to us, to the faithful. Only Jesus Christ did that. My dear sisters and brothers, think about it. Is it not a great thing? Is it not a thing that should comfort us in our daily travails, difficulties, pains, illness, sickness? Yes, Jesus is with us. And we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever because he is taking care of us. Let us pray for a moment. Lord Jesus, you have promised us that you will be with us till the end of the ages. And we know that, Jesus, you are faithful to your promise. You are faithful to your promise, and you are with us. You want to become part of our body. So you are giving us every day yourself to us in the Holy Eucharist. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for this wonderful gift that you are making every day to us. You are beside us. You are leading us to the green pastures and the still waters. We believe in that. And you are there with us, and we will be in your house forever. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Divine TV is made possible through the prayers and financial support of people like you. This noble mission of spreading the gospel is touching thousands of lives all around the globe. We receive hundreds of emails and prayer requests confirming this. In order to continue, we need your prayers and financial support. God is a God of promise. He will reward you several times over for everything you do to help us. Our only goal is to reach more lives every day with the message of Jesus Christ. To those already helping us, may God bless every one of you and your loved ones immensely and fill you with joy and peace that surpasses all understanding. Please send in your prayer requests and donations through dvnonline.org, or you may send in your checks to Divine Vision Network, Inc., 1791 OG Skinner Drive, Suite D, West Point, Georgia, 31833, USA. In Europe, please send your checks to Divine Television Foundation, 26 York Street, London, W1U, 6PZ, United Kingdom. In India, you may send your contributions to Divine Television Foundation, Angamali, Kerala, India, PIN code 683573.